Welcome back, dear students. I had started this poem, Indian Weavers, written by Sarojini Naidu. This is my second video. In the first video, I done the first paragraph, the brief introduction of the poem, and I've explained you what the three stanzas depict for, the three stages, the significance of the colors I will be talking about, and the significance of different the colors and their related emotions. So in the first paragraph, I talked about the newborn child, okay? Now in the second paragraph, let us begin with the second paragraph. Weavers weaving at fall of night. What do you weave a garment so bright? Like the plumes of a peacock, purple and green, we weave the marriage veils of a queen. So now again, this poetess is asking that she again meets the weaver and she's asking, at the fall of night, means during this night time, what are you weaving? Garment so bright. This garment, this piece of garment that you are weaving is so bright, so colorful. Like the plumes of a, you have seen the feathers of a peacock, na? They are blue, green, shiny, so many colors together. So similarly, if you can see, some motifs are also like that. See? So they are weaving such cloth, green, purple. So now the weaver is asking, answering the question that they are weaving the marriage veils of a queen. Veils is the front, the scarf kind of a thing, flimsy, through which you can see through. That scarf kind of a thing that the queens wear, we also called ghungat in Hindi, okay? So marriage veils of a queen. So now here this poet meets the, again, it refers to the evening or the dusk time, the when the sun has just fall of night. Not, it is the dusk, the evening time, when the day is ending and the night is beginning, that time. When the sun sets and the darkness has come over. So during this time, most of the marriages, they take place. So see that how from morning, now it is the evening time. What happens? The transition. And the transition of color also, the transition of emotion also, the transition of people also, see. Moreover, it is also the time during which most of the this marriages take place, and that is why the weaver is weaving during this time. The poet, again, she questions that this garment looks so bright with so many vibrant colors, like that of the feathers of a peacock. So what to, then the weaver is again replying that the weaver's reply is that they weave the marriage veils of the queen, thus referring to the second, or in the other words, adult stage of life. In the first stage, we had talked about the young age. Now it is the adulthood. Okay, first it was childhood, now it is the adulthood. So during this stage, the humans are quite active, they love each other, get married. Ambition is there, quest for prosperity is there, they want to do something better in life. So very vibrant, very active. That is the significance of the colors, the bright colors, very, very nice, beautiful, shiny. And they symbolize sorrow and happiness and or struggle and ease in one's adult stage. And these colors are of ups and downs of them that make the life or the adulthood so bright. Because in adulthood, what happens? You now know what is sadness, what is sorrow, what is happiness. And it is a mixed stage where you get to experience everything. So this is that stage. Because marriage, you know, the girl is also sad because she has to leave her parents' house, and happy at the same time because she is now going to a new house to start a new life. So many emotion embedded in one particular stanza. Now let us move on to the third stanza. Weavers weaving solemn and still, what do you weave in the moonlight chill? White as a feather and white as a cloud, we weave a dead man's funeral shroud. So now the third stanza, as you can see, depicts death. So first was childhood, a new beginning, adulthood, and now it is death. So he is telling that the poetess is seeing that these weavers very quietly, very slowly, very calmly, they are in a state of sorrow and in a state of grief. They are quietly weaving something. And what is the time? moonlight chill. Again, the dead of the night. And what is the night like over here? It is like the feather, white as a feather and white as a cloud. So the shroud, the when a person dies, we put a white cloth, cover the person or wrap the person in a white cloth. So that is the significance of white over here, that it is very, very white, like the feather or as the cloud, which depicts no color, colorless, lifeless. And the weavers, again, they are answering the question that they are weaving the dead man's funeral shroud. Shroud is that white cloth, because they have to take that man to the funeral who has died. So here in the picture also, see, for the newborn, for the marriage purpose, and then for the this shroud. So in the third stanza or the final stanza, the weavers are very quiet, sorrowful and grieved and silent. They are weaving something weird in the moonlight chill. And the chill is like that of the dead, as if it is very white, very colorless. As the poet, now she fails to figure out that what they are weaving. Why they are so silent, there is no activity. Why they are so sorrowful. And then she asks them out of curiosity that what are you weaving at this point of time, at this night time? Moonlight, moon again signifies, see, white color, white feather, white cloud, white cloth. So, and that is a shroud. So what they were weaving. So the again they reply that it is the cloth put on the dead body or a dead person. And here the third stanza depicts that it is the final stage of the life, which is death, where we are all emotionless and lifeless, like that of white clouds or white feathers. So in this way, you see how beautifully the poetess, she has told about three stages of our lives, what they signify, how differently we behave, and how life begins with joy, hope, happiness, and ends with sorrow and grief. Because anybody who dies, you see that we become very sad, we cry on departing with that person. So when somebody is born, how do you feel? Very, very happy. But during marriage, mixed feelings are there. And during that, we always are very, very sorrowful, sad. So similarly here also, full of sorrow. So here, see, the stages, the times have been used. The break of day, fall of night, moonlight chill, the different colors have been used to signify different things, happiness, mixed feelings of happiness and sorrow, and white signifies here, so grief. So, and how you see in the final stanza, all the colors, they vanish away and one single color remains, that is white. And you can understand that emotions are connected with life, and when the person dies, emotions also die. Because here, bright green, purple, red, golden, so many colors. So please, girls, this ends your poem. Please go through the poem very, very carefully, and I will send you the question and answers in a day or two. Thank you.